the news, the Democratic Party has summoned its leaders and senior members for a retreat to strengthen the party structures. This as Dr. Kizza Besigye's People's Front for Transition threatens to sweep out members of the oldest political party.
The Democratic Party Secretary General Gerald Siranda says the party has failed to benefit from opposition coalitions. He says the party loses members whenever it gets into alliances with other parties. The opposition has been a battlefield as political parties throw insults at one another following formation of People's Front for Transition led by Dr. Kizza Besigye. DP and NUP did not appear at the launch of the party.
We, again, don't necessarily have to join every new creation. We welcome every new creation as long as it is adding to the struggle, but it is, you know, we work with all these different people, you know, we operate with them, different political parties, different groupings and so on. They don't have to be merged, you know, and become one. We have the People Power Movement.
We have had waves since the time Besigye came with reform agenda. We have had I don't know now People Power. You understand? All these waves have come and they have gotten us only 3.5 million people, 3.5 to 4 million people as voters.
In that regard, the Democratic Party has called for a retreat of its members, which will take place this month. The meeting aims to bring its house to order after discovering that some of its members were joining Besigye's group without authorization.
It's scheduled for 23rd and 25th. 23rd, 24th, 25th and members' invitations have already gone out, and then we also need to do our strategic plan in terms of how do we want to run the party for the next 5 years. We also going to look at our constitution.
The Secretary General of the Democratic Party, Gerald Siranda, says coalitions have not done anything good for the Democratic Party. NUP swept over 10 MPs from DP following a failed party reunion.
As DP, we have been in every coalition. From 1960, before Uganda became a nation, DP led the coalition processes. We went to the coalition in Iruweru because Museveni did not have anybody in Iruweru. Those were DP. And he said they had leaked the DP election, not Museveni's election, DP election. We went to support him in that. We came out, we went to Haji Alagide, you know, under TDA. We supported FDC under reform agenda, rather, and it ended up in FDC. We went to the TDA. We've gone to every process, IPFC, IPC, what has come out of those processes.
The Democratic Party has asked politicians who are forming coalitions on opposition to give it a break because they are focused on building their party structures. Siranda says they will only consider coalitions a year to the next polls.
We should spend energies building those forces, I've said. Build the communities we come from. Mobilize Ugandans to work with you. Build your political entity so that when you come as a serious bloc to benefit that coalition. Otherwise, if you just take me as Siranda, I would be the DPSG. But have I come with the DP? Have I come with where I come from? Have I prepared people? Oh, I am on the running and we do press conference and then we go on the road.
Political analyst Dr. Mwambusha Ndebesa and Professor Ugeala Tigo say the Democratic Party is right to fear for its life inside coalitions.
They have fear and suspicion that being under one person, under one leadership of a certain political party will undermine the profile and the identity of the other parties.
They have called for a Kenyan mode of political coalitions where alliances are registered as legal entities with clear agenda and terms and conditions in order to cure the mistrust.
Let them have an organizational model which does not profile only one individual or one political party, because they are all pursuing the same objective. And therefore, in my opinion, they should have a partnership or a network with a secretariat which would be the face of that initiative.
This problem is not opposition, really. This problem that we face in this country is all in the hands of President Museveni. All the constitutional changes were about him. Removing the term limit, removing the age limit, we're all about him.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.